Hi, in this 10-minute tutorial, I'll be walking you through some basic algebra. So what is algebra? Well, here's an example algebra problem on the board. 3 plus something equals 8. That's essentially algebra. So using your common sense, you'll probably know that the answer here is 5. 3 plus 5 equals 8. But how do we solve that mathematically? How do we solve that algebraically? Let's take a look. Usually in algebra, we don't use boxes to represent the unknown. We usually use a letter. So often X is the letter of choice, but you could use any letter, A, B, or Y, or Z, doesn't matter. So 3 plus X equals 8. So the goal in algebra is to get X by itself on one side. So ultimately, we want X equals something, right? Now, to do that, all we have to do is get rid of everything else on that side. So for example, here we have a 3. So to get rid of that, all we have to do is subtract 3, so minus 3. But in algebra, whatever we do on one side, we must do on the other. So because we subtracted 3 on the left-hand side, we must also subtract 3 on the right-hand side. Okay? So on the left-hand side, we'll be left with X. On the right-hand side, we'll be left with 8 minus 3. And as we all know, 8 minus 3 equals 5. So that's our final answer. X equals 5, as you probably guessed, without even using algebra. So let's do some practice problems. In this first question, we'll do a subtraction. So X minus 4 equals 10. Now, remember we have to get X by itself on the left-hand side, or the right-hand side, it doesn't really matter. Here we have a minus 4. So the opposite of minus 4 is a positive 4, plus 4. So to get rid of that 4, we have to add 4. And remember, whatever we do to the left-hand side, we have to do to the right-hand side. So we'll also add 4 on the right-hand side. So we'll get X equals 10 plus 4. Which equals 14. Now the good thing about algebra is that whenever we get an answer, we can immediately check it. You can always know if you're right or wrong. So here we have X equals 14. Let's check that answer by putting it back into our original equation. So X minus 4 equals 10. 14 minus 4 equals 10. That's right. So we know that's right. You can check yourself. Question 2, 3x equals 12. Now when we see a number before a letter, as in 3x, that just means 3 times x. Usually in algebra, people don't write this when there's a letter involved. Of course, if there's two numbers, you'd still write 3 times 3. You can't write 33, which would mean 33. But yes, when it comes to letters, it's safe to put numbers directly in front of the letter. So 3 times x equals 12. 3x equals 12. Because we're multiplying x by 3, the opposite of multiplication is divide. So we need to divide that side by 3 to get rid of the 3. And therefore, we have to divide the right-hand side by 3 too. So we'll end up getting x will equal 12 divided by 3. X equals 4. Remembering, we can check the answer by putting that back into here. 3 times 4 equals 12. Tick. Question 3, x over 4 equals 5. Now, if you know your fractions, x over 4 is the same as saying x divided by 4. So x over 4 equals 5. To get rid of that 4, we have to, well, because it's a divide by 4, the opposite of divide is multiply. So x divided by 4 times 4 is just x. Remembering, whatever we do to the left-hand side, we must do to the right-hand side. So in the end, we'll get x equals 5 times 4, which equals 20. We can test that by putting it back into here. So 20 divided by 4 equals 5. Tick. Question 4. What if this time we have x on the bottom of the fraction, so we're dividing by x? 2 over x, 2 divided by x, equals 4. In this situation, we can't do anything with the 2, we have to deal with the x first. So to get rid of that x, the opposite of divide by x is multiply by x. So do that to both sides. 2 divided by x times x just equals 2. They cancel each other out. 4 times x. Well, remembering in algebra we don't need to write the times symbol, the multiply symbol, so we can just write 4x. 2 equals 4x. Now that's a lot easier to deal with. On the right-hand side we have 4x. To get rid of that 4, so 4 times x, we do the opposite. So divided by 4. Do that to both sides. 2 divided by 4. We can just write a fraction. 2 over 4 equals x. Rewriting that, we usually write x on the left-hand side. That's just convention. X will equal 2 over 4, we can simplify to 1 over 2. So we can divide top and bottom by 2. This is just some basic algebra operations. So if we divide top and bottom by 2, we get 1 over 2, or 1 half. X equals 1 half. We can check it by putting it back in here. 2 divided by 1 half equals 4. It does. You can check that on a calculator if you want to. A shortcut to doing this, so if we have any number, so 2 over x equals something, a shortcut to changing, instead of doing all of that on the right hand, all of this here, we can just switch the bottom number on the left hand side with that number. We can just switch those numbers. So 2 over 4 equals x. That's just a little bit of a shortcut. I mean, you don't have to do that. But if you get good at doing these sort of things, you'll learn that just switching those two numbers is a nice shortcut. If you need to show you're working, I would recommend doing all of this. Question 5, let's do something a little bit more tricky. 3x plus 2 equals 14. Now, before we can do anything with this 3x term, we have to get rid of everything else. So we have to get rid of everything that doesn't contain an x. So here we have a plus 2. The opposite of plus 2 is minus 2. So subtract 2 from both sides. So we'll end up with 3x on the left-hand side equals 14 minus 2, which is 12, right? Here we can just divide both sides by 3 to get rid of that 3. X will equal 12 divided by 3 equals 4. Let's check it. 3 times 4 equals 12. 12 plus 2 equals 14. Good. Question 6, 4x over 3 minus 7 equals 1. We can't do anything with this first term, but we can do something with this 7. The opposite of minus 7 is plus 7, plus 7 to both sides. So we'll end up with 4x over 3 equals 8. 1 plus 7 equals 8, right? Just a note, if you haven't already noticed, the equal signs here, traditionally we keep them in line with one another. That's how, it's just a convention, I suppose, and it makes it a bit easier for people to read. So 4x over 3 equals 8. Now we can multiply this side by 3 to get rid of that fraction. So multiply this by 3 to get rid of that bottom 3. Do it on both sides. 4x over 3 times 3 equals 4x. 4x equals 8 times 3 is 24. X will equal, well, to get rid of that 4, we have to divide by 4, because 4 times x, the opposite of that is divide by 4, isn't it? Divide both sides by 4. X will equal 24 divided by 4, which equals 6. Let's check it. 4 times 6 is 24, divided by 3 is 8. 8 minus 7 equals 1. That's correct. Anyway, that was basic algebra in 10 minutes. The key takeaways are that we usually use letters instead of boxes, so 3 plus x equals 8, although you can use any letter that you like. The next thing that we should remember is that the goal is to get x on one side by itself in order to solve the problem. So in this case, we'll end up getting x equals 8 minus 3, or x equals 5. Another thing to remember is that we usually work downwards, and we keep the equal signs in line with one another. That's just a convention that makes it a lot easier for people to read or check your work. If you have any questions regarding algebra, please leave them for me in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Cheers!